Welcome to Chase Field, Phoenix, Arizona, round two of Monster Energy AMA Supercross and FIM World Championship. Jason Wygant, Jim Holly here at Supercross Live on supercrossonline.com. It is round two, technically, by schedule, but it's almost round one in a lot of ways, Jim, because you know what it's like racing this game. Opening night, there's a lot of jitters, and a lot of times riders ride a lot better once they get away from California.
Yeah, and you mentioned some of those guys, you know, like a guy like Davey Millsaps. You know, a lot of people probably scratching their heads. You know, he came out last weekend, wins the heat race for Honda. That hasn't been done in a while. And then all of a sudden in the main event, he gets ninth. So it's hard to say. Josh Hill had a sixth. He rode good. But, you know, Josh had to come. He was in the back of the pack. He had to work for it. And but, you know, a lot of guys, they get into Anaheim and they go, you know, this is the first one. They're tense. Now they know what to expect. They know what to do in practice. A little bit of a different routine as far as practice goes. There's three practices now, mm-hmm. as opposed to two in the past. So, you know, they're just kind of now they're getting into the groove. They know what to do, and I think the racing is going to be a lot more better here in Phoenix. Traditionally, it is a good race here, both on the lights and the 450 class.
Now, the big story coming out of Anaheim, Chad Reed, who is now looking at a huge points deficit after just one race. It's almost already must-win time for Chad.
Well, it is, but you know, on the other hand, I think it took a lot of pressure off Chad, you know, because now he is behind. So if something happens, you know, he can just say, well, look back to Anaheim 1 where I lost all those spokes. I got together with Austin's troop, blew out a bunch of spokes. But on the other hand, a lot of people called me this week, surprisingly, and says, hey, how come they didn't have a spare wheel in the pits to change that? And I go, wow, you know, it's the first round. Nobody really does it. I mean, I know when it comes down to a championship, the mechanics will carry down a wheel just in case something like that happens. But, you know, in a short race like this, you know, it's 20 laps. The race is going to be about 18 minutes usually. On the average, you really don't have time to run up to the truck and get a wheel and come back. But I guarantee you that in years upcoming, you might see that where guys just, hey, traditionally the top three guys that are in the points or have a chance to be for the championship, they will carry spare wheels.
Yeah, Kawasaki threw a lot of points away there, and the guys that Reed is going to have to catch, of course, James Stewart, who won the race last week. And how about Ryan Dungey leading about 16 laps and actually nearly passing Stewart back on the last lap?
You know, a lot of people thought that, you know, would Dungey, you know, crack under the pressure, but he didn't. I mean, Dungey is a seasoned veteran. I mean, if it would have been 2 years ago when he was battling with Jason Lawrence for that championship, right, I would say, yeah, but Ryan Dungey's matured a lot. He's ready to go for this championship. He is the guy at Suzuki, and he's Suzuki's hope to win a championship. And, you know, leading it, he's come off a lot of championships. Like we said, he won the Supercross Championship last year in the lights. He won the Motocross Championship. He went over the Donations. But a lot of people forget that Ryan Dungey did ride a 450 a couple years ago and finished second in Minnesota, and he's got that time in Italy for the Motocross Donations on a 450. Ryan Dungey's only going to get better.
Yeah, that's dangerous to think about that because he almost won the race last week. And don't forget, we'll also have a great West Region Lights competition tonight. Jake Weimer looking for two in a row. Trey Kennard coming out of the pack with a close second last week. Should be a great showdown between those riders. Stay tuned right here for all coverage during the day on video, and don't forget, subscribe to our Supercross Live webcast tonight. There is not going to be live TV from Phoenix. So if you want to know what happens as it happens, you must subscribe to our webcast, supercrossonline.com/supercrosslive. He's Jim, I'm Jason. We'll be there. We hope you will be too.